The Belt and Road Initiative is basically a colonial infrastructure enterprise, which they are seeking to get the countries most immediately involved to pay for. It's called a debt trap. I think of it as kind of a payday loan scheme. They get them to pay for port modernization or for building a railroad or for building airfields or what have you on terms that they can't possibly pay back those loans. And then the Chinese close on them, and then they own the airfields and the ports and the trains and so on, having made these loans that were simply unsustainable. But the point is, Kevin, at every step of the way, those infrastructure developments, and by the way, at least as important, as we've talked about many times in the past, is the digital infrastructure that the Chinese are putting into place as well, alongside these physical ones, because those will enable them to control communications and information and, you know, fundamentally the economies of these countries as they are becoming more and more and more impoverished and vassal states of the great Chinese Middle Kingdom, the empire that they haven't had for a few centuries, but they're interested in reconstituting. And at the end of the day, they know that the one real impediment to China's dream being fulfilled, as Xi Jinping, the president, says, is the United States of America.
Yeah.
And as a result, they are working hard at supplanting us. They're building institutions as well as these kinds of infrastructures designed to de-dollarize the world's economy,
yeah,
as you've taught me.
De-Americanize the world.
These are enemies of the first order. We underestimate them and their determination. Maybe not this year, maybe not next year, but in the very near future, I'm afraid, to supplant America without firing a shot if they can, but probably using violence if they feel they need to.
Well, you know, it's interesting. Part of what they're doing is they're using our capital against us. And I remember you invited me to the press club, and when Alibaba was the largest initial public offering in history, and from an economic standpoint was a bad deal, because you buy shares in Alibaba, you get a Cayman Islands corporation, you have no share ownership rights, no shareholder rights whatsoever.
No transparency as to what's going on.
But they took $25 billion and they've been investing that, buying other American assets that now have gone away from being our treasure to being Chinese treasure.
Yeah, you mentioned the asymmetric threat symposiums that we've been at in Washington. I was at one yesterday, and I mentioned that, you know, there seems to be a Chinese modification to the quote, I think it's apocryphal, but it certainly was trenchant, attributed to Vladimir Lenin, that the capitalists will sell us the rope with which we will hang them. Well, the Chinese fillip to that is the Americans, the capitalists in the West, will finance the purchase of the rope with which we will hang them. And a case in point, as we've talked about, Kevin, is apparently on the Frankfurt International Capital Market, the Chinese have sold dollar-denominated bonds to pay for the aircraft carrier that they will ultimately be using as part of this military threat to the United States of America. And that's just one example, and I'm afraid that probably their whole Blue Water Navy and a lot of other things besides, you know, just to give other calibration points on the commitment the Chinese are making to their military, including the part that very directly threatens us, is they've built 3,000 miles of hardened underground tunnels in which to hide the nuclear missiles that they are aiming at us and make them essentially invulnerable to any kind of protection from us.
3,000 miles underground of tunnels.
That's roughly the width of the continental United States.
Yeah, it's unbelievable.
The most immense public works project, I guess, since the Great Wall of China. In fact, they call it the underground Great Wall of China. Only this one has nuclear warheads on it.